Hi everyone, in this lecture I am going to discuss the multi-fetal gestation or the multiple pregnancy, and in the part of this video we are discussing about the varieties of multiple pregnancy. So what is a multiple pregnancy? It means when two or more fetuses are developing inside the uterine cavity at the same time. So there are number of varieties in the multiple pregnancy depending on how many the fetuses are developing inside the womb. So depending on the number, we can generally prefer some of the terms to denote the number of fetuses. So let's see what are the terms. For the two, when the two fetuses are developing inside the cavity, we are terming them the twin. Okay, and when there are the three, we are called as triplets. And if there are the four, then we are called the quadruplets. And if there are five fetuses, then quintuplets. And if there are six, then we'll called as sextuplets. So here are the few terms depending on the number of fetuses, and out of them the most common is the twin pregnancy. So in twin, again there are the two variety. Let me show you. So one is the dizygotic twin. Dizygotic, and this is also called as the fraternal twin, and the binovular twin, and non-identical twin. So the dizygotic, it means when the two ovas are released from one ovary, or it could be from both ovary, one from the each, fertile with the two separate sperm at the same time in a single menstrual cycle is called the dizygotic twin. So by this variety, there are the two placenta which separate the fetuses with the four intervening membrane, and the four intervening membrane are the amnion, then comes chorion, chorion, and then amnion. So by this, the four intervening membrane, the fetuses are separated by themselves. And very important in this variety is that the sex of the baby may differ, but in the monozygotic twins the sex is always same. So in dizygotic there may be same sex or may be different, but in monozygotic there is always same sex of the baby. So in multiple pregnancy, what is the common variety? That is the dizygotic. Now comes the another variety which we are called as the monozygotic. So in the monozygotic twin, as the name suggests, what mono means, it is single. So there is only one ova which come in contact with the sperm to become fertile. Okay, so once it become fertile, again there is many more variety in monozygotic, because in monozygotic it depends when the division is going to take place. So once it become fertile and forms the zygote, and if the division takes place within 72 hours, if the division takes place within 72 hours, then the developing fetus would be DD. What is the developing fetus would be DD? It means there is two amnion and two chorion. Okay, when the division takes place within 72 hours after the fertilization. So in that condition also, this condition is almost similar to this one, only dizygotic. As we have seen in this, that there are the four intervening membrane. So in that also there are the four intervening membrane that separate the two fetuses, that is the amnion, chorion, chorion, and amnion. But in this we have studied that the sex could be differ and could be same, but in this condition the sex could be always same. Okay, so this is the one variety, DD. The another variety in monozygotic twin is the when the division is going to take place in between the 4 to 8 day. So within 4 to 8 day after fertilization, the developing variety is D, or you can say MD. Okay, so MD is the monochorion diamnion, because by that time the chorion is already developed and the amniotic cavity is only left. So the chorion is only one and the amnion are two. So the intervening membrane in between the developing fetus is only two, because there are only the two linings, that is of amnion, and the chorion is completely shared by these two fetuses. Okay, so there is only two intervening membrane in between the two. And the another variety develops after the 8th day of fertilization. After the 8th day, the developing fetuses of MM variety, because here what is happening, the amniotic cavity is also developed. So once the chorion as well as the amniotic cavity both develop, then the intervening membrane between the fetuses completely disappears, because there is only one gestational sac which they share. So there is no intervening membrane in between the two fetuses, and they are sharing the same sac. So this variety is called the MM. So out of these three, the most common one is MD, that is the chorion is already developed and there is two amnion in between the two fetuses. Okay, so most common variety in monozygotic is monochorion diamnion. And the another variety is when the division is going to take place after the two week of fertilization. Okay, so it is too late. So in that condition, what is happening, chorion and amnion is only single, and there is only gestational sac which is forming here is only one. But what is happening in this condition, the developing fetuses are here are called the conjoined, because they are joined by different part of their body, or you can say Siamese twins, also called as Siamese twins. So after the 2 weeks of fertilization, now the fetuses are joined by different body parts here. So these are the common variety in the monozygotic twin. And in monozygotic also, there may be a symmetrical and asymmetrical division. So in a symmetrical, we can see the DD as well as MD and MM variety, or maybe the conjoined varieties. But in asymmetrical, what is happening, one fetus will be normal and the another will be smaller. So this smaller one, acardius, that is the external acardius variety, in which the major body part is not there in the fetus and there is completely absent of the fetal heart rate in a smaller fetus, and that fetus is completely rely their nutrition on the mature one. And in the another variety of the external parasitic, in the asymmetrical variety, what is happening, again in that also there is a smaller fetus, there is no distinguished fetal body part is seen, and the another with the normal fetal body part gives the nourishment to that surviving tissues, and that completely parasitic on that normal one. So that also not survive more than the first trimester. The another variety which we call that the internal, that is fetus in fetu. In this asymmetrical division, what is happening, the one fetus is enfold itself into the mature fetal body part. Okay, that enfold and goes inside the fetal body part. So some rudimentary body parts, that is the vertebral as well as the axial skeletal system, with some masses could be found in that vanished part of the fetus. And the mature, the vital organ, the very important vital organs, that is the heart and brain, all are absent in that vanished part. And there are the few varieties also we can see here in the conjoined or Siamese twins. So in these variety, one you can see is the omphalophagus, and in this the fetuses are joined at the level of umbilicus. Next is the thoracophagus, where you can see the fetuses are joined at the thorax level. Cephalophagus, in which you can see there is a conjoined head and the upper portion of the body is completely fused, but their lower portions are separated. And the caudal one, that is the ischiophagus, in this you can see the fetuses are joined by the lower portion, and that is the pelvic region, that is about 180 degree, and there are the four limbs of the fetuses. So on a lateral aspect, the another variety you can see here is the paraphagus, Dysprosophus. So in this lateral variety, you can see two phased head you can see, and they are sharing the common body part. And in the another variety of the paraphagus dicephalus, they are the two head, but they are sharing the common trunk in between them. And in the dorsal aspect, the another varieties could be seen here is the craniophagus, in which the fetal head could be anteriorly, laterally or posteriorly attached by each other, but their body parts are completely separated. And in rachyphagus, you can see the fetuses are joined by the back region, and in a pyophagus, the fetuses are joined by the pelvic region. So we have seen the varieties in the conjoined twin also. Now the incidence of these twins, that is the monozygotic as well as the dizygotic, completely varies, because monozygotic is completely rely on the maternal environment, so it is constant throughout the worldwide. Like it is just appearing in 1 in 250 pregnancy, but the incidence of dizygotic is completely differ from country to country, because it depends on many of the factors. So before I show you what are the factors, just see what is the Helen's rule. So according to Helen, he said that the multifetal gestations are occurring in a mathematical formula, like twin pregnancies is usually occurring in 1 in 80 cases, and in triplet it is 1 in 80 square cases, and in quadruplet it is 1 in 80 cube. Likewise, it goes on. So the dizygotic twin completely varies from country to country, and it depends on many of the factors, and one of the factors is the race. And it is said that with the various researches that in a Negroes, that is in a black, it is more in comparison to the Caucasians, that is in a white person, because in them, that is in a black persons, the FSH level is more higher. And once this FSH is more in that condition, the more follicle will be mature at the same time and release more. So there is a chance to get multiple pregnancy in that condition. So next, the incidence is the hereditary. So it is found by many researches that if a woman is born itself by a dizygotic birth, then there will be a more chance to give birth to the dizygotic baby in comparison to a woman who is born by a singleton pregnancy. So there is a higher incidence among the woman who is born by dizygotic birth. Now next comes the increased parity. So with the fifth gravida onwards, there is a more chance to give the birth to a multiple gestation. Okay, and another is the age. So by the age factor, that is if a woman already crosses 30 and 30 plus, and if she is still nulliparous in that condition, if she is taking the ART therapy or ovulation induction therapy in that condition, what will be happen? More follicles will be grow at the same time, and there will be a chance of multiple gestation. So by combined use of ART as well as the ovulation induction therapy with the use of clomiphene citrate drug and the gonadotropin, they all are responsible for the multifetal gestation. So here is the super fecundation. Now what it means? So in this condition, what is happening? There is a release of two ovas in a woman's single menstrual cycle, and these two ovas are fertile with a two separate sperm cell by a different coital act, and it could be a by same partner or it could be a by different partner, and these both ovas become fertile with the individual sperm cell. Okay, so that is called the super fecundation. Now the another term is the superfetation. And this superfetation is common in the mares, that is in an animal. In a human it is quite impossible, or the spontaneous superfetation is a very rare one. Once a woman become pregnant, she get another good news that she is pregnant again. So that's why I call that it is quite impossible, because once a woman become a pregnant, in her body there is automatic system that suppresses the hormone that produces the ovulation. In such situation, what will be happen that if she is pregnant and once the deciduous lining is not obliterated, that is the decidua capsularis is not fused with the parietalis, till that time if ART techniques is used, in that condition only it will be happen that we are using the another embryo to transfer inside the uterine cavity of a woman. Nutrition also influences the dizygotic twinning, because if a woman is having good nutritional status and her height is adequate, in that condition she will be able to carry two fetuses at the same time. But if it is a short stature and if she is underweight, then it is not possible for her to provide nutrition for the two fetuses and more than that. So here we have seen the multiple factor that influences the dizygotic twinning. So in this part we have seen the varieties of the multifetal gestation as well as the incidences of the dizygotic twin. In next part we will be discussing about the how the maternal adaptation takes place to carry the two fetuses and more than that, but basically the two fetuses, and what are the diagnostic feature by we can identify the woman is carrying the two or more fetuses at the same time. Thank you for watching this video.